Hi, my name's Emma, and I'm a huge book nerd. You're my library, always open for business, but you never show it. You're just sitting with them, but I know the score, and you're killing it. Today, I am finally doing the No Disclaimer book tag. I was tagged a long time ago by Reading with Kylie. Thank you, Kylie. First question is, which trope or tropes in books annoy you the most? Insta-love and really terrible villainous parents in YA fiction. It's no disclaimer, so I don't have to explain. Which writer or writers do you feel are overrated or overhyped? John Green and Gail Forman. I do love me some The Fault in Our Stars, but that is the only John Green book that I truly like, and beyond that, I think they're all the same, and some of them are bad. And Gail Forman, I can't. Back to the insta-love thing. Number three, what are your least favorite books you've read since joining BookTube? Just One Day by Gail Forman. Insta-love and a terrible ending. We'll get back to that later. Grasshopper Jungle by Andrew Smith was just like a really horny teenage boy, and it was gross. Number three was The Mountain Between Us by Charles Martin, which was kind of sexist. All right, question number four, a terrible ending that ruined an otherwise good book. I couldn't really think of one for this, so I went with Just One Day by Gail Forman. Granted, even if it didn't have a really terrible ending, it would not have been a great book, but the ending, like, really ruined it. I was like, come on. Number five is, which fictional characters do you wish were not killed off? Okay, spoiler alert for It by Stephen King and Harry Potter. I'll do Harry Potter first so you can stick around. Everyone, especially Fred. I love Fred. And then Tonks and Remus, I think, are my other two that I really would want to keep around. Yep. Now, spoilers for It. If you haven't read It and you don't know how it ends, if you've seen the first movie, this is still a spoiler. It's a spoiler for the second movie, so go away right now. Bye. Eddie Kasprak! I love that boy so much, and even though he dies as an adult, Eddie! I need Eddie to live. It's so sad. Just leave him in the sewer! What? Why would they leave him in the sewer? I don't know. I get very passionate about it. It's very upsetting to me. Okay. Welcome back if you were away for the spoiler. Number six is, what are some of your bookish pet peeves? The biggest one I could think of for this is breaking the spine of a book. I hate breaking the spine because I love how my pretty spines look on my shelf and I don't want to break them, and it hurts me deep down inside when people break the spine. What are some books you feel should have more recognition? Ugh, I have got answers for this question. First big one, Highly Illogical Behavior by John Corey Whaley. If you have not read this, it is a beautiful YA book about a boy with agoraphobia, which means he's afraid to leave his house. So it's like about this boy with like really debilitating anxiety, and I like relatable, and also it's beautiful and like uplifting. I just really love this book and I seriously recommend it. As someone who is not a huge YA fan, this is an incredible YA book. The other is The Unlikely Pilgrimage of Harold Fry by Rachel Joyce. If you've been watching my channel since like the summer, you know how much I love this book. I read it earlier this school year and just absolutely fell in love with it. Like, oh my goodness, it's so good. Basically, if you want to cry and you want to experience some like magical realism while you cry, this is a wonderful book for you. If you like reading about old people, which seems to be a thing that's happening right now and a trend in the book world, like this is a great book for that. It's super underrated. I don't hear anyone talk about it, and it's a fantastic book. Number eight is, what are your thoughts on censorship and banning books? Don't do it. Use your own judgment if you want to read a book or not, but you should be able to read any book that you want to read, and just keep in mind who wrote it and what it's about, and don't take every book as fact, but you should be able to read every book. That's my opinion. And then the last question is, who do you tag? And I actually had a lot of fun prepping for this video because I didn't know who to tag, and then I went through and discovered some new BookTubers, and now I'm really excited to tag them, and I hope that they're willing to do the tag because I would love to connect with them because they all seem like such sweet women, and I'm super excited. So, first is clarareadsbooks. Love your channel, girl. Checked it out earlier today. I am a new subscriber. Then AlyssaReadsBooks21. Again, I love your channel. I think you're really great, and I hope that you will do this tag. And then Gabriella from Fictional Not Fantasy. Again, I am now subscribed to your channel. I really like your videos. I hope that you will do this tag. And last but certainly not least, Girl About Library, who I did not hear her say her name, but she's so sweet, and like, girl, I love Station 11 too, let me just say. So I hope that you all will do this tag, and if I did not tag you by name, you can go ahead and still do the tag and say I tagged you, that's fine with me. So that's it. If you liked this video, please like and subscribe and leave comments down below, and thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Bye! Mwah!